Yo, what's going on guys, envy astro here, back at it with another video. So in today's video guys, like I had mentioned a couple videos back, I was going to be showing you guys my overall configurator settings, because a lot of you guys had asked me what do my pits look like, what do my settings look like on either Betaflight or Butterflight. But I currently run Butterflight. For those people that do not know, I do have I think one quad on Betaflight, so but it's very similar to my Butterflight settings, so it's very, it'll be the same. Okay, so the only difference here, on the last video I showed you guys my very first Neutron build. I finally got one done. It's running F60 Pro V2s, 1750 KBs for 6S. It's running the Magnum stack, which has the ESC, the F4 FC, and then it has the VTX. But the VTX is not the greatest VTX, so I may be swapping that out for a Unify very soon, once I get hands on one. And I am running Foxeer V3 camera, the Lumenier Stubby here. And then last but not least, I am running the receiver for the Nirvana. If you guys don't know, I am currently just testing the Nirvana out. That receiver isn't the best just due to the fact that it has one antenna. And a lot of you guys actually commented down below whenever I did my first impressions. If you guys have not seen the first impressions on this radio, I'll put a link here on the screen for you guys. Go check it out. But basically I got fail saves, and a lot of you guys told me that the receiver just sucked. I did not know. I've never flown Fly Sky. So, you learn with experience. But anyway, before I get started with the setup and showing you guys what I run on Butterflight, a couple videos ago I did a video where I basically provide like a service type thing for a lot of people that are getting into the hobby, or basically if you don't like building things. So I provide like repairs for anybody, custom builds for anybody, and I also have that email down below where you contact me for that. Not only will you contact me if you have repairs or custom builds, but I've been getting a lot of emails with people having questions to solve their diagnostics, whether they're wanting to know how to pit tune, they're wanting to know what's wrong with their like motor, why it's twitching, their flight controller not connecting, or whatever it may be. I've been helping a lot of people out through that email. So if you have any questions or whatever it may be, I have that email down in the description below, or I could also put it here on the screen for you guys. But another thing, me and Set Handle are trying to reach 10K by the end of the year. So if you guys wanna support us and you like our videos, please smash that subscribe button and also show some love by giving this video a thumbs up. But without much further ado, let's go ahead and jump right into the Butterflight configurator. All right guys, so like I said, I do run Butterflight and my quad is already connected there. So let's go ahead and just jump right in. So the very first page you see is the setup page. Usually here, whenever you tilt your quad to whichever side you want, it will correspond to the quad on the screen. But the reason mine doesn't do that is just because I have my accelerometer off. Usually accelerometer is enabled for those people that run like angle mode, horizon, usually people getting into the hobby, or some people actually have it whenever they like lose video on their quad, or they, whatever it may be, they switch that switch on, goes into angle mode, and they're basically be going up. So a lot of people do have that enabled. Me personally, most of the time I'm racing, so I do not have accelerometer turned off, and that is why you are not able to see my quad corresponding to the movements I'm currently giving it to, for those people that don't know. So next tab is the Porsche tab. With this flight controller, the only bad thing that a lot of people actually complain, and that I complain about now, is that it doesn't have a spare UART for people that are wanting to run like Smart Audio, or I believe you're not able to run Smart Audio due to that extra UART, and this actually doesn't even work. Of course, I don't have the TBS Unify in there, so it's not gonna work. So right now, only my Betaflight OSD is working on this one. But yeah, a lot of people do complain because it doesn't have a spare UART. But I think if Emax comes out with a V2 and they make it a, they make the VTX better and they put an extra UART, I think it'll be golden. So I do have S-Bus enabled for one of my ports. Usually on all my other ones that do have spare UARTs, I have the TBS Smart Audio on. That way I could switch my channels for my VTX whenever I need to do that on the field. And let's go over to the next configuration tab. And this is basically like one of the main important tabs here for my setup. So let's go ahead and kind of look at the mixer. So this is what my quad looks like. Usually stock, the motors are traditionally spinning towards the camera and stuff, and then towards the back, which is the rear. So they're spinning this way, and then in the front, they're spinning inside. But I personally like running my props to run the other way. So these arrows right here, they'll indicate to where the props will actually switch. And there's not really a specific reason. Well, there is a specific reason, but there's not a reason as far as flight characteristics why I fly my reverse props. There is some people that do say they feel a difference as far as like tuning, they feel less prop wash. Me personally, to tell you the truth, I don't really feel a difference as far as how the quad actually feels. But the main reason I do fly that, the reverse prop, is because it tends to clean my lens. I'm sorry, it tends to keep my lens clean while I'm running my quad, and like if I'm crashing in grass and stuff like that. So I definitely have seen an improvement in that. And since like last year now, I've been running the reverse prop. So that is what my prop configuration looks like. And then as far as my ESC motors, this is a 32K ESC here on the Mini Magnum. So I am running the D-Shot 1200. Usually on my other quads that are just rated for D-Shot, I run D-Shot 600. Personally, I also cannot feel that difference between 600 and 1200. But some people say that it just feels a lot more resolution. And the throttle, like I said, I'm not too picky on that, those type of things. But like as far as like different props and stuff, I am able to feel that difference just because I look for a certain thing in props. And idle, usually motor idle usually comes at 4.5 stock. I do it at 2.5. It is a little bit lower than 4.5, obviously, but it's not a huge difference. So I'm just fine 2.5 to work, and that's something I've been running for a long time that I used to run way back whenever the props used to be really, really like slow. But then it became a problem when I had it like real low, because whenever I was flying and I let that throttle all the way down, it'll sometimes get under control and air mode wouldn't kick in. So that is, I found 2.5 to kind of be that sweet spot. As far as my board sensor alignment, with this specific flight controller, the way I have it tilted in there, I do need a 90 degree on the yaw degrees. Usually on my XSR F40, that FR Sky built-in receiver flight controller, I do put 180 on my yaw just because that's the way I wanna rotate my flight controller for that one. My system configuration here, like I said, my accelerometer is turned off, barometer is turned off, and my magnometer is turned off. So I do just kind of free up some CPU load there. But I do go up on the kilohertz here for a gyro update frequency. This flight controller is able to do an 8 kilohertz, so I have it maxed out. And the PID loop frequency is able to do 8 kilohertz, so I also have it maxed out. And then accelerometer trim, I don't mess with that. Personalization, that's basically if you have enabled OSD on the flight controller, whenever you're flying, it's going to display whatever you have under that craft name. And for me, I have Envy Astro. I like letting people know I'm flying in the air, so they could tune into my channel when I'm flying or whatever they, or if they just want to know who's up in the air, they know to just look at my channel and hey, it's Envy Astro. As far as my receiver goes, this current receiver, I believe it does run iBus and SBus, but I currently run SBus on the receiver just due to the fact that I'm not too familiar with the receiver or the settings yet, but it is able to run the iBus as well. I currently have an SBus with the Nirvana, so, and that's usually what I run. I usually run SBus on everything else, except one of my Crossfire rigs. When I used to run it, I used to just run it on Crossfire, which you go over here and just change it to Crossfire right there. But I am running SBus, like I said, so we'll switch it back to SBus. And then the other features, 3D, of course, I'm not running 3D and I don't have GPS on my racer, so that's disabled. Other features, usually air mode is turned off. I usually turn that on just to always permanently enable air mode. I just like flying with air mode. OSD, I do have like having my OSD on. That way it could display my my voltage and stuff like that. And then ESC sensor, I don't know exactly what this means, but it says, use with kids or BA-32 as far as like your telemetry feedback coming from the ESC, so I do not have that turned on. Usually I think people turn that on whenever you are using it for like amp, your amp meter or something like that. I believe me, do not quote me on that, but I think people turn that on for that. Since I don't really mess with that, it's not on. Anti-gravity, this I definitely turned on. So just kind of how it explains it here, a temporary boost I term on high throttle changes, meaning if you guys ever have like an issue where your quad is, when you give it a high pump, so whenever your throttle looks like this and you kind of just giving it those little pumps, and then your quad looks like this, oops, whenever your quad looks like it's doing this every time a little bit on the pitch axis, enable that, and also you'll increase your eye pids, and I'll show you what mine look like compared to actually stock. So it'll definitely help with the tilt on its pitch axis, and whenever you actually give it throttle, it'll try to just maintain really just stuck in there in that angle. So I enable that. So I definitely enable that just because I have found it to really help whenever I'm racing. And as far as dynamic filter on, I have that on. D-shot beacon configuration, I have that off. That's basically your ESC making those motors beep. So if you ever disarm for an amount of time, it'll make those motors beep and you can find your quad if you don't have like a finder on the quad or anything like that. As far as the beeper configurations, that's all kind of stock settings. Let's go ahead and move on to the next tab. We have the battery tab. So this here is the onboard ADC for my voltage meter source, onboard ADC for my current meter. I don't have a current meter, so it's, I believe that is stock as well, but I do have my voltage meter on this to be able to display my voltage. And minimum voltage cells is 3, is pretty low just due to the fact that you guys should know how I run my batteries. If you guys don't know by now, go watch some of my videos, you guys should know. 4.3, I charge all my batteries HV usually. Warning cell is at 3.5, I think, for stock settings. PID is another one of the important tabs. So right here, guys, so briefly, let me go ahead and show you guys what it looks like stock. So pay attention to the eyes. So right here, the eyes are very, very low compared to what I fly on. And the D's aren't too far away compared to what I fly on, but this is what the D's look like stock. But now let's go ahead and change it to my PID. So right here. So look at those eyes. That's what I was talking about. This matched up with the anti-gravity. It feels very, very nice and locked in. I like to feel very locked in on whichever axis I'm either leaning towards, whether it's the pitch axis or the row axis. That is why my eye is that high, 70 and 75. D's go down by about 2 points on each axis, and then P's kind of increase just a little bit to feel a little bit snappier. And then my super rates, I've been messing with these a little bit more. This allows it to feel a little bit more sensitive at the middle. So I used to run 0.53, and then 0.5 on yaw, but I went up a little bit just so I could be more sensitive and I don't have to move my sticks too much. As far as pit controller settings, I don't know too much about this, but Seth Handel did briefly speak to explain this like a couple months ago, and he's like, dude, you gotta do this, it makes your quad fly better. And so I did. It's basically the VBAT pit compensation, where it makes the pits kind of compensate to your voltage, what your battery is. So it makes them feel very similar to whenever you had a high voltage compared to whenever the battery is close to the its end of the cycle. So the if you want that feel, turn on that VBAT pit compensation on. As far as TPA goes, stock comes at 0.1. I found that 0.25 kind of helps with all my rigs. As far as high throttle, I don't get any oscillations or anything. Just kind of relaxes everything out, and I don't get any of those oscillations. So I always stuck with TPA ever since I used to run the Tokyo, and ever since I put it on my Protons, even though I may need it or not, but it does not affect it in a negative way. So that is why I keep it at 0.25. And then we go over to my receiver tab. It's kind of self-explanatory. Oops, I'm about to run out of battery, but so far we're 14 minutes in, that is okay. Alrighty, so this is basically my channel mapping. Usually this comes at default. It comes at AETR, but I do run mine on Spectrum because the radio is for TAER, meaning throttle, aileron, elevator, and rudder. Let's save that again. We go over here to modes. Modes, I only use 2. That is one for my arm switch. And then we slowly come down here, and it is the flip over to after crash, meaning it is the turtle mode enabled, and that's the only 2 switches that I need. I mean, I know this radio gives you like more channels for any other things, like people that fly planes or anything like that, but for drone racers, I really need only one for arm, and I only need one to turtle mode, me personally. Motors, there's not really anything I need to show you guys in motors. You guys, basically it shows you the quad, and it shows you how I have reverse motors. OSD, one last thing here before I basically end the video is I don't like having too much stuff on my screen just because I don't like it bothering me while I'm flying, but basically I have my low voltage warning, which I tend not to really listen to. And although I do have my voltage there, I sometimes do glance at the voltage, but I don't really tend to listen to it a lot. Usually I do have the RSSI enabled, and I have it up here with my XSR F40 since that does provide telemetry. But with this flight controller and receiver, I don't think it provides telemetry. So I do not have that enabled. So I only have my voltage, my low voltage warnings, and that is it right there. So that basically wraps up my configuration as far as Butterflight goes. If you guys still have any questions regarding like my setup and why I run those specific setup, just let me know in the comment section below. I'll try to answer your questions. And if you also do have questions, remember I do have that email, reach out to me and I'll try to get back to you ASAP. So I hope this video wasn't too long. I hope I wasn't too boring, but without much further ado, catch you guys on the next one. And stay tuned because Sethando and I will be doing prop reviews on the 5055 Hulkie S, meaning strong. We are coming out with the 1250 milliamp battery 6S China Hobby Line, first impressions and torture test. We also have sticky icky battery pads, like a fun video coming out. We also want to do like a review video for freestyle frame. So for those freestyle pilots out there, we're gonna kind of switch it up, make a little bit fun video. We have a 4S versus 6S video coming out. So if you guys like to hear our opinions on that video, tune in, subscribe, help us out, reach to those 10K by the end of the year. But without much further ado, hope you enjoyed this video and peace out.